Hey guys, welcome back to GKCodelabs. This is Arpit here again with another session in Apache Spark series. Since our last session, we have started Spark-SQL module. And in our last session, we discussed about what is data sets, data frames, the differences between them. And if you have not seen that video, I'll link that in the I button. Please go watch that video. And this is the next session in Spark-SQL module. So let's go through the Spark-SQL section, what Apache Spark has officially provided. This section we have already discussed in last video. So if you are following my video in that series, after watching my last video, the first topic that might come to your mind very obviously is how to create data frames and data sets, because that is what Spark-SQL is all about. And here in the documentation also, they have mentioned the starting point, that is Spark session. So what is Spark session? Spark session again is an entry point, as we have discussed in RDDs. The entry point was Spark context. But after Spark 2.0, again they have introduced Spark session. That is again an entry point to Spark engine, but with a lot more features. All those features were there earlier as well. But with Spark session, you can access them using only Spark session class. So now let's see how with the help of Spark session, we can create or deal with data frames and data sets. So how do we create a Spark session? Let's code it right away. I'll open my IntelliJ. I have created an object and I have extended app so that I don't have to make a main method. Now, first of all, to use Spark session, you need to import the Spark session library. If you are using IntelliJ and you want to use it here, make sure the Spark session is included in your external libraries. For that, when you are using SBT, you can mention this dependency into your build.sbt, that is Spark SQL, the latest version as per your Scala version. This Spark SQL includes the Spark session class. I'm moving back here. Once you have imported Spark session, how can you create a Spark session object? Let's create a val Spark, and you can simply use Spark session dot builder class. Same thing they have mentioned in the official documentation if you want to go through it. Now, same way as we used to define the Spark context, let's define a master for this Spark session. So we can do that by dot master, and whatever master you want to define. For my case, I'll mention local and all the codes. After that, if you want, you can mention the app name. I'll mention Spark session. And finally, you have to mention get or create. That's it. Our Spark session is created. So Spark session is this Spark variable that will provide you an entry point to Spark engine when you have to use Spark session for whatever the reason, creating a data frame or data sets, whatever it be. So now let's see very simply how we can create a data frame using this Spark session. So when we have to create a data frame, let it be df, we can simply use Spark, the Spark session object that we have defined, spark.read. Whatever type of file you have, see, it has different formats, CSV, JDBC. For the purpose of this video, I have taken the example from Spark repository itself. I have copied this data.json. This is a JSON file. Let's try to read this file into a data frame. So spark.read.json. And here we have to mention the path of that file. So let me copy the path itself from here, copy path, and just paste it here. I think it didn't copy. So that's it. That is how simple it is to create a data frame with the help of Spark session. If you want to see the data, let's do a df.show. Let's run this. You can see same way we are getting the age, name, and the data in that data frame. You can see it has passed the JSON. So the keys are the column names and the values are the values in that data frame. The same way you can also pass CSV, text file, or whatever format you have. So this was as straightforward as it looks to be. Here they have mentioned different functions that you can use. df.printSchema to print the schema. And not only here, you can find a variety of functions that usually you might have heard. This is just to clear your concepts. Once we come to solving the questions using the data frames, then we can solve different scenarios using the data frames or data sets. Just a small look you can have how you can access the different columns of the data frame. You can use it by df.select the column name, and this will again return you a data frame, and you can fire a show function to access that. I'm not going to run this because these are very small examples. You can try it out if you are practicing and let me know. I don't think you will face any issue. These things are straightforward. Also, you can access either by the column name in double quotes, or on the other hand, if you want to operate something on the values of all the values on that column, you can use the dollar column name. Suppose you have to add something to age, so you can access that by dollar age and do whatever you want over here. And there are similarly many functions that can be applied to a column, in which case you have to use this dollar sign. Similarly, all the data frame functions, filter, group by, again, all these things I have mentioned in my Spark transformation and action series. Please watch that too. I'll mention that in description. I don't want to go again and again. And one more thing, not only my previous videos, these all the things will be covered once we come to the hands-on. And hands-on I'll try to keep in the way that we solve some of the questions and the live scenarios. So these are the small things to practice. Just make your concepts clear by then, that how you can access the values in a data frame. So these were the operations that can be done with help of different functions like group by, filter and all. These functions can be applied to a data frame. But when it comes to Spark-SQL, the main purpose of that is to enable you to also use some people that are experienced in SQL, to enable you to use SQL-like queries and perform those operations using SQL-like queries onto data frames. But that SQL queries, whatever filter group by you are using, that will be done on the Spark engine. So for that, there is a feature of running SQL queries programmatically. So in our next video, we'll see how we can run the SQL-like queries like select star from whatever the generic SQL format, how we can run on a data frame. So thank you guys for watching this video. Please hit that like button, and I request you to subscribe to my channel if you really like the content that I post. Thank you guys. See you in my next video.